Hello guys, in the last video on ED25519, there were several interesting comments and questions regarding this key type and SSH in general, so I will address those starting with host key fingerprints. Whenever you open an SSH connection to an IP address that you have not contacted before, your SSH client will ask you to verify the fingerprint of the public host key. And that fingerprint is nothing but a hash of the pub key. The hashing algorithm that has been used is shown at the beginning of the fingerprint. And technically, you can take the pub key, hash it with SHA-256, and the result encoded base64 should match the fingerprint. But of course, you don't have to manually do that. There is an easy tool for that called SSH keygen. Typically, you would run the command with the LF flag to generate a fingerprint for a particular pub key. RouteRes does not have this tool, but if you want to be diligent, you can take the host public key and generate the fingerprint on your computer. However, this key will not change between devices that are connecting, so you might as well just copy the fingerprint when you are absolutely certain that there cannot be any man-in-the-middle stuff going on. However, I should add that the current implementation of our SSH client, which is what you would use to connect from one router's device to another, does not perform the host key check and hence it does not show you the fingerprint. I know this might have raised your ears, but let me assure you that the SSH server is perfectly safe. And when you are connecting to a router's device directly, you are using the SSH client residing on your computer. So if you want maximum security, just connect to the router's devices directly. The built-in client is more for convenience when you want to configure something quickly. But I think the risk of falling for an SSH man-in-the-middle attack, especially in your home network, is really tiny. If they got on your network, you kind of failed already. They have accessed your property physically or they compromised one of your devices remotely. Those are some nightmare scenarios that most likely will never happen to you if you follow some basic security principles. So I think if you just have a couple of devices on your LAN and you want to use one of them to execute something on another one, you're probably fine. Just use common sense. Another interesting thing that one of the viewers pointed out is that you cannot change the key size of ED25519, and that is absolutely correct. I had to look into it and turns out that the cryptography behind the key is entirely different. A lot of security solutions, including RSA and Diffie-Hellman, rely on a very simple principle. Computers can easily multiply large numbers, but then factorizing to find out what numbers were multiplied is exponentially more difficult. The ED25519 also relies on a similar principle, but instead of prime number multiplications, it makes use of what is called elliptic curve cryptography. With this method, you have a formula for an elliptic curve, and then there is step-by-step process that has you arrive at different points on that curve. I don't really understand it, but essentially there are a lot of unknowns that an attacker would have to know to perform these curve calculations and decrypt your message. The cool thing about this solution is that since it is all based on functions and not on large prime number multiples, the critical bits of information can fit in a very small key size as opposed to having to store a very large number inside your key. In fact, the ED25519 key is designed to be only 256 bits large, but it is estimated to provide similar security to a 3072-bit RSA key. But we have to respect that when it comes to security, there are often no clear-cut winners. There are always pros and cons. ED25519 might be as difficult to crack as longer RSA keys using normal computers, but there are reasons to believe that quantum computers might find the elliptic curve cryptography algorithms to be among the easier targets. But back to the main point. The ED25519 keys are fixed size. RouteOS, the SSH keygen, and other software cannot do anything to change it. It will always be 256 bits, which in fact is the exact same size as the SHA-256 fingerprint. Another noteworthy comment asks how someone could manage the keys when you have several employees and thousands of routers? It is a good question because key mismanagement is one way how companies get hacked. They keep adding keys to whoever needs them, but then when keys are accidentally lost or the employees leave the company, the old keys don't get revoked. So key management is an important issue that probably deserves a video on its own. As others commented, you could try Ansible or plain old scripting. Finally, someone asked when ED25519SK will be available, as it could be used in combination with YubiKey. Currently, that is not in the plans, but if you could give me a hint on where to find the technical specification for that type of key, then I could pass it on, and the odds are the support would get added pretty easily. So if you know where to find the documentation for this key type, give me a hint in the comments. Just know that YouTube deletes comments with links, so you might have to be a little creative. Anyhow, enough talking, have a nice rest of your day.